Well, welcome, everybody. I'm so excited for this session. We are going to be visiting with TikTok, and we're here for all the small businesses in Austin and the surrounding areas to figure out how to connect and grow your business with TikTok. And I'm hoping both all of you had a chance to see the opening, but if it didn't make you want to be a TikTok star by the end of this webinar, you're going to want to be a TikTok star. My name is Laura Huffman, and I'm the president and CEO of the Greater Austin Chamber of Commerce, and we are delighted to partner with TikTok to feature local business owners who are creatively using this platform to reach a wide audience. I first learned about TikTok at a Sunday dinner with my kids when nobody was looking up from their phones. And they showed me this app, and it's really, really fun. And for those of you that haven't used it, our friends at TikTok are going to tell you everything you need to know in order to get yourself and your business up and running on this amazing app. Like a lot of you, we at the Chamber also had to pivot. We had to go from an organization that had all of our events and meetings live to doing everything online and in production. It wasn't easy for any of us, but some of the tools that are available do make this easier. And they also give you access to whole new audiences that you may not have been thinking about before we all went online. So as we all evolve and leverage the tools that we've got, establishing an online platform like TikTok really is important. You'll reach new audiences. People will see you in your business in a whole new and different way. And so this webinar is all about promoting your business. And I'm super excited to welcome Blake Chandley, who is here with us. He's the Vice President of Global Business Solutions, and also Becca Sawyer, Head of Small Business and Operations for TikTok. So Blake and Becca, welcome. I think we're all looking forward to being TikTok stars here at the end of this hour. So teach us how to do it. It's all yours.
Thanks, Laura. Well, you definitely don't want to see me do a TikTok. I have done a few, and my wife suggests that I stay on the business side of things versus trying to become an influencer. We really appreciate you having us. I'm actually joining you from a small business up in North Austin. It's a group called Omega Studios, and we're filming some stuff here. And so I'm in the green room in my jacket because it's cold. So I apologize that I'm not joining you with a beautiful background. 2020 has been a challenging year for many, and I think we acknowledge that. And there's nobody that's probably faced greater challenges than small businesses, not only in the Austin area, but across the country and really across the globe. And so one of the things that we at TikTok are really focused on is trying to create moments of joy for our community around the world. And that joy could take many different forms, but our mission is to inspire creativity and bring joy. And so it was funny, I recently read an article that called TikTok the last sunny place on the internet. And it is a place where people go when they just need a little break or time for a laugh or a giggle. And what started out as a platform of content that really was driven around kind of lip syncing and dancing has diversified so much over the course of the last year. And you're as likely to see videos and TikToks around comedy and cooking and travel and sports as you are anything, depending on who you are and kind of content you enjoy. For me, and I've been with the company just about 2 years now. I'm based here in Austin and spend time obviously around the world, but the last 9 months it's been nice to stay here with my family and just kind of enjoy the city that we all love. One of the things and one of the big trends we're seeing in content is really people are drawn towards local content. So content that, you know, is consistent with their experience in their communities. And so small businesses start becoming amazing creators. And so that's something that we think is unique to TikTok and something that we really want to dig into and support, not only for the small businesses themselves, but for the community in general. And so, you know, I'm really proud that Becca, who's also an Austinite, is leading that charge for us across the U.S. and other parts of the world. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to Becca to dig in and have a few guests, and I'll leave it to you, Becca.
All right. Well, thanks, Blake, and thank you, Laura, and the Austin Chamber of Commerce for having us here today. I'm Becca Sawyer, and I lead the SMB and operations teams for TikTok here in the U.S. While I'm not an Austin native, Austin has been my home for the last 7 years, and I've just fallen in love with this city, and I think so much of what makes this city amazing is the community. And, you know, SMBs really are the lifeblood of our community, and they play such an integral role, as Blake mentioned, in the TikTok ecosystem. So super excited to have the privilege to be here today to spend time walking you through, you know, who we are as a platform and ultimately how you all as small businesses can use TikTok to really reach your customers and to have the chance to hear from some of our very special Austin small businesses themselves and how TikTok has really been transformational for them in this very unprecedented year that we've had. So just in terms of our agenda, you know, we're going to just spend some time talking through how to really partner with TikTok and how that can help you break through the clutter to be discovered and ultimately really be able to reach and connect with your audience. And, you know, what does it look like to drive results, and what can success ultimately look like for your business here on TikTok? And, you know, despite these existing and new challenges that I think we've talked about, there is a ton of opportunity for small businesses. 2020, you know, as Blake mentioned, has certainly been a really interesting and challenging year for us. Many industries and businesses have been turned upside down due to the pandemic and the lockdown. And, you know, you as small businesses, as well as your customers, have really had to deal with new challenges and go through a bunch of new shifts in order to adjust to what is now the new normal. And I think it's really important for us to remember the year of pivots that it's been for customers as well. And shoppers are saying that the pandemic has impacted not just the way that they shop now, but also the way that they will shop going forward. And we're seeing that customers are really expecting even more from brands and businesses now. 76% of customers have said that they expect companies to really understand their needs and expectations. 70% expect connected experiences. So these are interactions that are personalized based on their actions and demographics. And 67% say that their perception of brands has changed. They're really expecting that businesses are more empathetic and that much more human. So given some of these massive shifts from consumers, we understand that, you know, you as small businesses face a number of key challenges, and you're thinking about everything from, you know, how do you get your brand discovered? How can you as a small business really build awareness, especially in what can be a noisy ad space? You know, how can you really reach new customers? Where do you invest in order to maximize your reach and impact? And how do you navigate the digital landscape? There's a ton to do when it comes to keeping up with the trends and the new digital opportunities. And that can be really tough when you're wearing a lot of hats as both a small business owner and marketer day in and day out. But what we're seeing is that those SMBs that really embrace being flexible and responsive and adaptable are really able to take advantage of that deep customer loyalty that SMBs are able to build with their customers. You know, you all have intimate relationships with your customers, and your customers are here to support you. We're seeing that not only are customers stepping up to support small businesses, but they're open to trying new brands And they're really using digital channels for inspiration. Customers are buying from brands that are helping them discover new things in a very personalized and relevant way. And online is really ripe with opportunities, especially if you are able to connect with your audience in that real and meaningful way. That's ultimately what we see is going to help drive conversions in the long run. So I want to spend a few minutes just talking about why TikTok is the right partner to help you build awareness and drive results for your business. As you heard from Blake, and as you'll continue to hear throughout this presentation, you know, consumers are really craving authenticity and connection and creativity. And those are ultimately the core tenets of our platform and what makes TikTok really special. We are fresh and unique and such a great place for your business to be discovered. And we are really a source for entertainment and delivering those joyful experiences. And, you know, as we see audiences moving away from content that can feel inauthentic or overly curated, customers are looking for real and positive experiences. And they're looking for that source of inspiration, that sunny spot on the internet. And, you know, TikTok is really the home for that. We've had the opportunity to give everyday people like you and me the ability to make content and ultimately show up as themselves. And, you know, within this special community that we've been able to create, we certainly are welcoming tons of brands and businesses every day here as well. And, you know, as we've really opened the door for those real and diverse users to express themselves and come together, I think TikTok has been able to foster a sense of community in a way that no other platform really has been able to do. And we've become a global community that has been able to break down barriers and borders and generational divides. As a business on the platform, you are a part of the TikTok community. And as a member of that community, our users are going to join alongside you and participate. And that really sparks connection and inspiration and co-creation and ultimately that entertainment as well. Shoes, look at my work shoes, club shoes, falling on the budget shoes, like a DSW. These my favorite sneakers, my slippers, my size. These shoes are all right. These ones are crazy, and these are my favorite. So while there are many outlets for content consumption today, and it can sometimes feel like consumers are hard to reach, the good news is that your audience is on TikTok and they are constantly creating and discovering content. And as a platform, we are experiencing such tremendous growth. We've quickly become mainstream with over 100 million monthly active users in the US, which is double what it was this time last year. And ultimately, we don't just reach your audience, but we are really capturing their attention at a time when attention spans are diminishing. The audience on TikTok is highly engaged. According to some recent research, users are spending 347 seconds per session on TikTok. And to put that in perspective, compared to other platforms, that's over five times the amount of time spent per session on platforms like Snapchat. And users are spending more time on TikTok per session than Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Pinterest. TikTok's also bringing together a segment of the audience that can't be reached on other platforms. And for you as small businesses, that really represents an opportunity to engage with new audiences that you can't reach elsewhere. For example, almost 40% of our users are not on Instagram, and over a third of all TikTok users are not on Snapchat or on Facebook. And I think most importantly, TikTok is unique from other platforms when it comes to being that source of entertainment and inspiration. A recent survey showed that above other social platforms, TikTok inspired users to find out more about a brand or product. It helped users decide what to buy, and ultimately it inspired them to shop and make a purchase even when they weren't necessarily looking to. And lastly, we are an open platform that's really built for that discovery, which is what makes it easier for users to find your business on TikTok versus other platforms. TikTok, for those of you who may not be on it yet, opens into a full screen sound on stream of videos. And there's a personalized for you feed, which really fuels that content discovery and consumption. And our algorithm uses a content graph rather than a social graph. So why is this important? Well, this means that businesses like yourselves can reach new users beyond your base audience. TikTok has really democratized content creation so that every post can be seen and engaged with by non-followers and really ensure that great content gets the reach that it deserves. So it really doesn't matter whether you are a user or a small business or a large brand. It's about how you show up on the platform and being a part of our community. Join the conversation and participate. Welcome people into your business and, you know, really enjoy and take advantage of the rich storytelling and creativity that's possible with everything that we offer. We're going to spend just a few minutes walking you through how you can think about specifically driving marketing and business results on TikTok. So TikTok business accounts are specially designed accounts for businesses, and having a business account gives users access to a variety of tools and functionalities, including analytics on posts and call to action buttons. And you can really use your business account as your brand homepage to be able to link all of your brand information and content together. And TikTok enables you to tell your story, connect with your audience, and drive business results through both a mix of organic and paid content. So we wanted to share some examples of some great creative and authentic organic content that our three Austin-based businesses that we're gonna hear from a little bit later today have created to give you a little bit of inspiration. I think everybody's going to be hungry after seeing that one.
There was a big beehive under the floor of this shed, but as soon as I started to remove the hive, most of the bees moved to the outside wall. So I started to scoop the bees into the new hive with my hands. As a professional beekeeper, I've learned how to read the bees' behavior, and I could tell that these bees were calm and did not want to sting me. They just wanted to get into their new hive. So I kept scooping bees off the wall while looking for the queen bee. When the bees are gentle, I prefer to wear as little protective gear as possible. The less gear I'm wearing, the more dexterity and agility I have. After scooping most of the bees off the wall, I didn't see any signs of the queen. So I went back in the shed to look for her, and there she was, surrounded by her attendant bees. I put her in a clip to keep her safe, and as soon as I put the queen in the new hive, all of the other bees followed her pheromones and went into the new hive on their own. I waited for all the bees to get into their new home. Then I closed up the hive, and it was another great day of saving the bees.
All right. Well, that was some great content, and very excited to hear more from these three businesses about their experience in a little bit. So as you get comfortable with the TikTok platform and really connecting with your audience through your organic content, we offer the opportunity to then be able to amplify your reach and drive the actions that you really care about for your business through the ad solutions that we offer. And TikTok Ads Manager is our self-serve platform, and it's really designed for quick and easy setup for every level of expertise. We offer flexible budgets and intelligent targeting and a suite of creative tools and templates, as well as data-driven insights that ultimately help you make those smart investment decisions for your business. And through this self-serve ads platform, we offer full funnel advertising solutions and specific goals that you can select when setting up campaigns on TikTok. If your goal is awareness, you can run a reach campaign to get your business discovered by as many people as possible. If your goal is consideration, you can run a traffic campaign to increase visits to your website, or video view objective to allow people to learn more about your brand. And lastly, our conversion campaigns allow you to run campaigns to drive what you consider to be the most important actions for your business. So that could be form submissions or purchases or other important conversion events. And TikTok's algorithm ensures that your ads are delivered to your audience. And this is important to note, as every time you create ads on TikTok, this is exactly how your ads will be matched with the best audience. And when your ads are delivered, they are inserted into the personalized feed of your targeted audience. Our in-feed ads allow you to tell your story, and they're really great for building awareness, growing your audience, and ultimately engaging with TikTok's community. Those in-feed ads can be targeted from broad to more specific audiences and come with a huge range of calls to action. And those in-feed ads will appear in the For You feed in between user content, which really enables you to seamlessly be a non-disruptive part of the overall user experience and dialogue on the platform. We also offer a suite of creative tools that enable you to really embrace that creativity and authenticity of the TikTok community that we've been talking so much about, and ultimately help make video ad creation simple and easy. Just to highlight a few of the available tools, our video templates provide templates to really help you easily assemble your video ad. And I'd specifically call out the Smart Video Soundtrack tool. Music is such an important part of the TikTok platform and is really key to leaving a lasting impression with consumers and building a strong brand image. Our Smart Video Soundtrack makes that sound on environment that much easier by offering background effects and access to copyrighted music for your TikToks. So we'll leave you with a few best practices to keep in mind when running campaigns on TikTok. First, you know, really lean into those brand building objectives that we've talked about, introducing your brand, really showcasing your personality and demonstrating your product value so that customers can get to know you and what your business is all about. We encourage you to really start with broad targeting, which enables the algorithm to find your best performing audiences. Use those creative tools that we just talked about. This will really allow that creation of authentic and unique content and also allow you to quickly test and learn what's resonating with your consumers. Design for that sound on environment to really grab the user's attention, and make sure that you're updating your creatives often. So we recommend at least every 7 days to ensure that your engagement and campaign performance stays high. And wanted to close with a great case study from a small business. Slate & Tell is an independent jewelry brand that offers meaningful and creative ways to personalize jewelry. And when Slate & Tell came to TikTok, they were looking to build awareness of their brand leading up to their peak selling season during the holidays in Q4. Knowing that TikTok was a newer platform, their initial goal was to see a 2x return on ad spend within 6 months. And the results they've seen so far have really exceeded their expectations. So to tell you a little bit about what they did, they used the Smart Video Creative tool, and they were able to easily create fun and engaging video content, which we'll show you in a little bit. And running conversion campaigns, they optimized towards upper funnel events like add to cart and product page views, which ultimately led to an increase in performance and traffic to their campaigns and improvement in their return on ad spend. And the results they saw were pretty phenomenal. They were able to reach over 4 million TikTok users. They tracked over 1,000 add to carts within a single session of a user being exposed to their ad. And they saw that 2x return on ad spend that they were looking for. I'll leave you with this quote from Isaac, who, similar to you, is probably in many of your shoes as the CEO of his company, Slate & Tell. And he shared with us the why TikTok, and ultimately the endless potential that he has highlighted is fueled by many of the things that we've talked about today. Our explosive platform growth and engagement, the access to exclusive audiences, which are not reachable on other platforms, and ultimately the value of being an early adopter and builder on the platform and being able to capitalize on the future growth. These are all things that contributed to Slate & Tell's success and that we hope brings light to the opportunity for how TikTok can ultimately help grow your business. All right, well, thanks so much. Hopefully everybody enjoyed that presentation and preview into the platform. So next we're gonna move on to a conversation with three outstanding local Austin businesses and discuss how they're finding success on TikTok. And just so everybody knows, towards the end of the panel, we'll open up the floor to the audience and we'll be selecting questions for the panelists from the chat box for further Q&A with them. So make sure to submit your questions for them. All right. Well, welcome, Erica, Karen, and Gabriella. Really excited to have you with us today. And I'll do a quick introduction for all of you before we jump into the questions. So starting with Erica, Erica Thompson is the founder and owner of Texas Beeworks, a beekeeping service offering private beekeeping lessons and bee removals. Gabriella Bucio is the CEO of Gabriella's, Mi La Vida, and Taquero Mucho, three businesses in the restaurant and entertainment industry that have quickly become go-to spots for the Austin community. And last but not least, welcome to Karen Keller, who's the founder and president of Gold Rush Vinyl, a company that specializes in high quality, fast turnaround record pressing. So thanks to all three of you for joining us. And to kick us off, I'd love to just have each of you introduce yourselves and tell us about your business in your own words and what inspired you to join TikTok. So Erica, we'll start with you.
Sure. Hi, all. I'm Erica Thompson, founder and owner of Texas Beeworks. And, a lot of what I do on TikTok is just showing what I do every day as a beekeeper. And I've been on TikTok, I guess, about 7 or 8 months, and it's just completely changed my business and my brand for the better. So I've had some great success on the platform and would highly encourage everybody to, you know, if you're not on it already, get on TikTok, spend some time on the channel, figure out what you like to watch and how you can show folks the incredible things that you're doing with your business.
Great. Gabriella. Oh, I think you might be on mute.
I'm sorry. Oh, can you hear me?
Yep, all good.
I'm Gabriella. I'm the owner of Gabriella's Downtown, Mala Vida and Taquero Mucho. We joined TikTok to show our creative side, be able to show our audience that we're more than just a restaurant. We're a vibe. It's a very artistic restaurant. It's pink. Taquera Mucho is really pink. So yeah, I just wanted to show our unique side.
Great. And Karen.
Hi, I'm Karen Kelleher. I'm the founder of Gold Rush Vinyl, and we're actually a B2B company. We're a manufacturer that makes the vinyl records that musicians then sell at record stores and on tours. And our inspiration for starting TikTok was twofold. One, at the beginning of the pandemic, obviously the music industry took a real tumble and concerts across the globe were canceled. Most of our orders come from bands that are touring. So I got concerned about diversifying our revenue and starting to think more about targeting consumers instead of just targeting B2B customers. But I'd also mentioned to our fantastic intern, Grace Troutman from University of Texas, that I've been paying attention more to what TikTok users are going to be doing to my industry than what the current customers are. We're trying to think 5-10 years ahead, what is the behavior of vinyl buyers going to look like? And that starts with communities on TikTok. So we've had a tremendous experience there building up new revenue streams on the merchandise side, and also using TikTok as a focus group, a very, very large focus group for things that we want to do in our company in the future.
Great. Well, welcome to all three of you. And would love to just dive in with some more questions for you. So Erica, back to you. I mentioned the first time we spoke, your bee removal videos are fascinating to me. They gave me chills as I saw you working with the bees and was fascinated at your ability to quickly find the queen bee. It's clear, you're not an influencer, you're a real beekeeper, and this is your everyday job. So, tell us a little bit more about the type of TikToks on your page and how you've really grown your business through this type of engaging content.
Yeah, it's been an incredibly rewarding experience. And I think what I really want folks to understand is that, like you said, Becca, I'm not an influencer. I'm just showing people what I do every day. Before this, I was out keeping bees. I got a queen clip on my shirt. I'm going to go clip some bees after this. But you don't have to have fancy equipment. You don't have to have a lot of experience, being an influencer. Everything I film, it's not for the sake of creating content. It's just showing people what I'm doing as a beekeeper, showing people what a normal Tuesday looks like for me. I use an old iPhone 7 and a $15 tripod for Amazon. And, my first few TikToks weren't necessarily the bee removals, and my first bee removal TikToks weren't necessarily, great and didn't go mega viral. And so I would just suggest finding what works for you, what you want to show folks about your business or what it is that you do. And as you've said, TikTok is such a great platform that really champions creativity and authenticity. And I think we're in such a unique place here in Austin. We're surrounded by creatives. We're in a city whose slogan is Keep Austin Weird. So chances are, if you have a small business here, you're probably already doing something kind of cool and unique anyways. So just use the platform to show folks.
I love that you can show your everyday job without, the frills of needing a big marketing team, and that you're able to find that success on the platform. What's been your most popular video on TikTok that you've produced?
I had a compost bin bee removal, which is one of the most common removals I do during peak season. I can do 5 a week, but I had one up in Round Rock in someone's backyard that I just set my iPhone up on a rock and just filmed the normal bee removal experience. I started to film and capture bee removals mainly to show the client that the work was done. But I shared this video on TikTok one morning as I went to another bee removal, and it was maybe August or, really hot month here in Texas. I was going back to my truck during the removal to get water and get cooled off, and I was checking the app, and every time I refreshed TikTok, I would have millions of more views. So that bee removal went mega viral. It had over 1 million views every hour and just changed my business overnight. It was the best opportunity and experience that, I could have ever asked for as a small business owner.
That's incredible. Gabriella, so your businesses are women-led, which is amazing. And, you know, your bright pink Te Quiero Mucho is such an unforgettable staple in the city. You know, how have you really used TikTok to build further awareness of your businesses in the TikTok community?
We've used it to reach to a more younger crowd, a different demographic. We've been able to use it to reach to other states, other cities all over the US. A lot of influencers, a lot of people come because they want to shoot TikToks at the restaurant because it's super cute, it's super bright, our branding is really cool. So we have a lot of people that want to come to shoot TikToks at Te Quiero Mucho.
That's incredible. I mean, I think it's so cool that, you know, you're not just helping your business, but you're also serving, I think, as creative inspiration for so many other creators on TikTok. And so cool to just hear that, you know, people will drive or fly to do a TikTok at your restaurant. You know, I think you mentioned that your restaurant opened towards the beginning of the pandemic. Is that right?
Yes, we opened during the pandemic. Well, we opened and then we got shut down after a month or so. But we were able to do to-go and grow our to-go business because of TikTok.
That's great. So tell me a little bit more about, you know, how has TikTok helped with those adaptations that you've needed to go through?
Well, just being able to reach to our audience, be creative. And it's just original content that we do. It's not an ad. It's just us speaking to our audience. And that has been able to help us by being connected to our followers.
That's great. And, you know, for the creators that are flocking to your restaurant to use Te Quiero Mucho as a backdrop for their content, you know, what has this meant for you?
I mean, I love it. I never thought about it when I created Te Quiero Mucho, but I love it. And we love that they come. And it's been really great.
What's been the biggest hit in terms of a TikTok either that you've created or that an influencer has created using Te Quiero Mucho?
We have several. We have influencers from other cities that come and they want to showcase Te Quiero Mucho. We have like San Antonio foodies, Dallas foodies, Houston foodies that come just to create that content. So we've had several of them have gone viral.
Awesome. So Karen, switching over to you, you know, you mentioned certainly having your intern Grace run your account, which I think is a unique strategy that you've adopted. So tell us a little bit more about that and how you came to that decision.
Well, it's funny. We spent about a month trying to get the login for our TikTok account because I had registered it a long time ago, but I didn't understand the platform. It's not what I, you know, was native to. And one thing that Grace and I sat down and did, and with the help of our production team to get the videos, is to look at what content was missing from popular vinyl hashtags on and categories on TikTok, and also what other categories were similar to us because we are B2B, we're not a consumer business, that we could learn from. And some examples that Grace found were things like people mixing paint, like how popular the process videos were, how popular candy making companies have gotten. She showed me one from Australia that had huge success with just showing how candy's made. And one thing we discovered is largely because my industry is such an old industry, right? Like it hasn't seen a lot of innovation since the 70s or 80s, that there weren't any videos on TikTok about the process of how vinyl records are made. And yet vinyl had something close to 3 billion views on various hashtags. And so we sat down and looked at what process videos we could show that are interesting behind the scenes things that would interest people that looked really like eye-catching and compelling on the page. And one thing I learned too, and now understand a lot more about the TikTok platform is, you know, hashtags that might work on Instagram don't work on TikTok. TikTok has its own language, you know, trending sounds make a huge difference. So one of the videos we're most proud of is sits at the top of the hashtag vinyl check. Tag, which you don't see on Instagram, but that's very native to the TikTok platform. So we've had a lot of fun seeing what content moves and doesn't move as quickly. But ultimately, I think people love seeing the process behind it. And we're the only ones that can show them that as in the factory that makes the vinyl records they love.
Great. Well, I think, you know, you mentioned, I think, a couple of other really unique things about your business. So one was that you're a B2B company, and that you found now unique ways to really attract and engage with general music consumers while also being able to stay true to your loyal vinyl buyers. So tell us a little bit more about that.
Yeah, it's wild. The first couple videos we put up, I was looking, I was like, wow, these are a lot of views on them. And I went to bed one night and woke up in the morning and our website crashed. And we didn't even have our website listed. This is a real story. We didn't even have our website listed in our TikTok account because we weren't recognized as a business account yet. That many fans of vinyl went out of their way to find us on Google and hit our website and hit our order page thinking they could buy vinyl from us that it crashed our website. And I was totally unprepared for that people would come into our business that way. So it's kind of shown us, wow, there are all of these vinyl buyers out there who want to know about the process. They're asking us, you know, we engage very actively in the comment section, and that helps a lot with our videos. But engaging these fans to say, what kind of content would you like? If we could make your dream record, what would it be? You know, finding out from them. And that's what I mean. It's a little focus group. We're learning a lot about how younger vinyl buyers are thinking about the market, how many of them don't even own a record player, but like love watching the process. And even the more that you engage in the comments, it really shows that you care and help. And it's giving us a ton of perspective that's driving our strategy for 2021.
Probably aren't many times that you are happy about your website being crashed, but that is a great example.
Yeah, no, I was shocked. I really was. And partly because I figured, oh, it would just be views and it wouldn't translate to anything. So, you know, for us as a business, this has been a real brand awareness thing. It also gives us opportunity then to go to bands that we do want to press records for and say, if you press here, look at this audience we've built on TikTok. Look how many more fans we can expose your record to. And in an indirect way is giving our B2B business just that much more clout in the music industry.
And I think one of the things that you mentioned that has been new and innovative for you is on the merchandising side. Mm-hmm. So tell us a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so I have some props here because just to explain it better. But when we manufacture records, we have waste material that really can't be recycled anywhere else. It's a peculiar kind of plastic. So we have things like pups like this that come off our machines. This is a record before it gets pressed. Or like this material, which is called flash, that gets trimmed off of the records. And we started to turn this into merchandise. We started selling flower bouquets made of our flash material and our records that otherwise would go in the trash can, and set up an Etsy store and sold close to $3,000 of merch off of that from our trash. I mean, we would be recycling this. And so we've created these new channels for that. We started also selling some of this material to artists. The artists on TikTok who use vinyl as like a palette for what they do is a huge community that we kind of tapped into. And so we've been finding ways to upcycle all of this waste, which is, you know, we're a very low waste facility to begin with and are really have an eye on sustainability, but now it's actually monetizing that for us in a really cool way.
I love that. I mean, creativity and how you've expanded your business and turned your recycled trash into both, you know, a new revenue source for your company, but also, you know, a source of joy ultimately for your consumers.
Oh, it's so much fun. It's so much fun to see people posting the photos and videos of their bouquets when they get them.
Well, super incredible to see, you know, three local businesses in vastly different industries that are finding their own communities on TikTok. So I'd love for each of you to share the advice that you have for other local businesses that are looking to emulate the success that you've found on the platform. So Erica, maybe I'll kick it off with you.
Yeah, I would just say be authentic, be versatile, you know, mix it up, figure out what works for you and for your business. You know, I've had a lot of success with one type of video, which are the bee removal videos. And I was a little nervous to post some more, you know, strictly educational content, but had great luck kind of diversifying and posting things that, you know, I didn't know if they would do that well. So I would say just start by spending time on the app, figure out what kind of videos speak to you, what you find yourself watching, and, you know, figure out a way to drive brand engagement through educational content or entertaining content or funny videos, whatever it is that's kind of your special sauce as a business.
Gabriella, what's your advice?
Get on TikTok. Ask, if you don't know how to use it, ask people around you. I'm sure there's a lot of people that are willing to help you. There's a lot of creatives. Everybody's on TikTok, so I think there's a lot of help out there if you don't know how to use the app or don't know how to create content, I'm sure you can find help.
Karen, what about from your side?
I think definitely find people like our intern Grace that know the platform well to teach you, because like I was jumping into it, and I think until you understand how positive an environment TikTok is and how like curated the pages get for users, it's hard to understand how to make the right content for it. And understand it is a different platform than other social media, you know, communities, because it is very community driven. There are lots of people you can tap into, but the way that you might make a video for Reels on Instagram is very different than TikTok if you want it to be effective. And so use it as trial and error. I think that the ease of using TikTok makes it easy to try different things and see content like what Eric is saying, an educational video versus, for us, videos of the process being made versus what records we've pressed in the factory. And we test those different things and have patience to see, if a video is not popping off like some other ones did, to take that as a lesson for how we might improve our content later.
Well, definitely all great advice. I'd certainly echo everything that you all have shared, getting on the platform and not being afraid to ask for help and experimenting. I think those are all really, really core to being successful. And, I also think the success that you all have seen really speaks to the authenticity of TikTok and the openness of the community to just really welcome in businesses of all sizes and backgrounds. So one last quick rapid fire question, Austin style. So tell me your favorite thing about Austin and the Austinite community. Erica, I'll start with you.
That y'all are bee friendly, it's a very environmental and green city, and I'm so thankful that I don't really have to sell my services. Everybody wants to help me save the bees. So thank you, Austin.
Gabriella?
I love how friendly everyone is. Super friendly, weird, always willing to try new things. It's a super fun city to live in.
Karen?
I love how much support there really is for the arts and music community. When I moved here, I was skeptical. I was like, is it, they just say that? But I've, especially during this tough season with the pandemic, I've been blown away by how people are using their creativity to keep our community together and find different ways to support the people who've been really hurt by all of this. So I love being a part of this community and supporting musicians in particular.
I would definitely echo that. I mean, I think my favorite part about Austin is just the amazing community that we have and how they will just rally and come together around any cause. I'm a huge dog lover. Austin is an amazing dog-friendly city. And just even to see the response from the community during the pandemic when the shelters were in need and how many people signed up to foster and adopt dogs, really, I think, just spoke to the power of the Austin community. So thank you to everybody who's a part of this amazing city. Well, great. I think we're going to move into questions from our audience. So let me jump in here. Audience question for Erica. How did you start beekeeping? Is this something that you've always wanted to do?
My whole life, I've just loved bugs growing up. That's what I was into. And about 10 years ago, I saw the opportunity to take a beekeeping class, took that class with no intention of becoming a beekeeper. I just wanted to learn more about bees as a species. So I didn't always want to be a beekeeper, but I quit my office job about 2 years ago to be a full-time professional beekeeper and throw myself into the bee business, which I had started about 5 years ago. And it's been great. Haven't looked back since. I've got the best job in the world.
Audience question for Karen. What's been the most surprising aspect or key learning of having a B2B business on TikTok?
Ooh, I wish I had been ready for all the consumer traffic and interest was going to come our way. I feel like we're getting there now, but I was shocked by how fast our account reached people. And like I said, I went to bed one night and I was like, wow, 10,000 views, is that a lot? And a friend of mine was like, that's a lot. And I woke up the next morning, there's 800,000 views on our video and our website was down. So, we weren't ready to filter consumer interest from our B2B business, but it's showing us that there is that business unit. I just wish that we had maybe had our website set up to direct TikTok users in a different direction, which we now do, and it helps a lot to kind of keep the two units separate.
So a question I think for all of you, and Gabriella, I'll start with you. So when making videos, what works best for you? Are you sticking to a certain type of video, or do you find better success by mixing it up?
We mix it up. We go by the trends. Also, whenever we have a new product, new merch, new drinks, new food items that are coming out, we'll plan a little TikTok session to showcase it to our followers and audience.
That's great. I'll be on the lookout for that. Erica, what about you in terms of content?
No, I would say definitely mix it up. You know, people always want to see something new and exciting. I think TikTok is really a platform for people who want to learn something. There's a big educational component that I didn't realize when I first joined TikTok. But I would say mix it up, figure out what works for you and your business, and keep it new.
And Karen, from your side?
For us, I think paying attention to the people who are engaging with the content. You know, one thing, I've been shocked that we've had like no trolls or negative content on our feed. The people who do stop to leave comments generally are very excited about what you're posting. But we try to listen to their requests for when they ask us, can you post a video about how vinyl actually, how do the grooves work? Or like, you know, a specific song that they have in mind. When we do that and we show that we listen to them and go back and tag them and say, hey, we heard your comment, it just instills more trust that there's real people behind the feed, that it's very authentic, and that they're not wasting their time on our page or account.
So I think a question from the audience for me from the TikTok side was, what types of businesses would perform best with TikTok? You know, I hope that today's presentation and also the panelists that we have just give everybody insight into the fact that the community that we have welcomes every business, every brand, every type of user. We have such a diverse platform, such a diverse community. And, you know, I think as you heard from all the panelists, you know, the best thing that you can do, you know, as a business and a user yourself is really just get on the platform and understand that community. And I think you'll quickly see that, you know, regardless of what industry you're in, that there is a home for you on a couple comments that are coming through from the audience. Sabrina from Amazon says, I love Piquero Mucho when I went in October. Diana calling out, love Gold Rush Vinyl. And from Jackie, I definitely follow Texas B-Works. She is fantastic. Some other questions that we have coming through here. So here's a kind of a fun question for all of the panelists. What's a TikTok song that you can't get out of your head?
Oh, we've spent a lot of time thinking about the music for our videos because we've learned we can channel certain audiences by putting certain songs in our videos. So one of the ones that we play a lot is Harry Styles. There's a huge One Direction audience on TikTok, and I will go home with watermelon sugar stuck in my head for days at a time if I'm looking at our content. It's really mad. I mean, the sounds you use in your videos can draw a whole new audience in, and it doesn't need to be literal. That's one thing we've learned is even though we might be pressing a record for one artist, it's more effective to use music from another to pull attention over to the video.
Erica?
I think I got on TikTok when Savage Love was like the biggest TikTok, you know, music piece used. And the artist is Jason Derulo, and he actually called me to do a bee removal. So, you know, that's always stuck in my head. And I will always associate Savage Love with TikTok.
Wow. And what about you, Gabriella?
For us, it's going to be anything from Megan Thee Stallion. She is Texan and super feminist. And that's the artist that we use a lot, and a lot of our TikToks and influencers use at our restaurants.
Awesome. So another audience question that I think came through for me on the TikTok side. So how important is organic content for businesses when compared to ads and influencer efforts? You know, really the recommendation that I have here is, you know, if you're a new business joining the platform, really getting comfortable with the organic space first, I think is a great place to start. I think it really gives you the opportunity to, again, get to know the community, really experiment with what works from a content perspective, how to build that presence and that voice for your business. And, you know, from there, as you then start to really understand those things, there's an opportunity, you know, to think about how you amplify that, whether that's with ads or whether that's partnering with our creator marketplace. So, you know, kind of finding that phase journey that's right for you. But I think certainly starting on the organic side is always the recommendation that I give for businesses that are new to the platform. So maybe one last question, I think we'll be wrapping it up. But some audience advice, that we're looking for here from the panelists. Somebody said, I own a cleaning company in the Austin area. Would it be effective to have TikTok for my business? What are your creative thoughts there? Karen, maybe I'll just
have my stuff sent out to dry cleaning today, and I have no idea how that process works, but I get it done all the time. I think it's one thing that's nice about a business like that, right, is that it's a really big audience for everybody needs dry cleaning services, right? Or, you know, specifically in Austin, where there's so many professionals and people who, you know, care about going out. So you have a huge audience of people that would be interested in this even casually, even, and I bet you if you look on TikTok like we did, it's probably a category where the process is not really shown. You know, you deliver your laundry and you get it back, but showing people the process behind it, I've been blown away how many people are just really interested in how things are made and how much TikTok has facilitated that.
Great. Well, anybody else have any closing comments or advice for our audience and small businesses?
Just stick with it. I would say start on the app and figure out what works for you, you know, and there's no better time to start than now.
Yeah, I would say stick with it too, because especially when you first land in TikTok, it's not curated for you yet. The more you use it, the more you start to see the power of it and how great the content is specifically for you. But when you first land there, because you're a new user, you're going to see a whole mix of things. So give it some time, start using it, start finding videos you like, and then you'll start to see the power of the communities that are developing there.
I would say get on it, get creative. It's free, so we should all be on it.
Great. Well, thank you again, Erica, Gabriella, and Karen for joining us. And for those of you who are not on TikTok yet, please follow our amazing panelists. We have Erica's at Texas BeeWorks, Gabriella's at Taquero Mucho Austin, and Karen's at Gold Rush Vinyl. So definitely pop over to check out their great content. And thank you again. And with that, I'll pass it over to Laura Huffman to close this out.
That was great, y'all. Thanks. It is especially good to see so many small business women on this panel. So thanks for that. I literally Googled every single one of your businesses while I was listening to you, because I found myself getting so engaged with vinyl flowers and what the menu items are, Gabriella. And Erica, I mean, you're just killing it with bee removal. So it's engaging. And all of those videos are neat. I think we all learned something. So Becca, thanks. This is the kind of thing that we love to bring to our small businesses in Austin. We all know that a lot of our small businesses have had a particularly rough year. So any tools that we can put in their hands to get more business, better business, to make connections, or I love it that your mission includes the word joy, just to bring a little joy into the world. And so as we head off into the holiday season, thank you all so much for teaching us how to use this platform and how to engage people, find new customers, and bring a little joy to people's lives. Thank you.